What's up, Giants fans, Hub watchers, YouTube subscribers, Twitter and Instagram followers? It's Kush back at again with another Giants video. And for this one, I just gotta say, some Giants fans really make me question about what they thinking, man. I've been seeing floating around on Giants Twitter, mostly Giants Twitter. I've seen it, you know, in a couple YouTube comment sections and whatnot. But the idea that we should cut and or trade Sterling Shepard, and I'm just like, how and why? Sterling Shepard, probably our best wide receiver, right? Now, him being our best wide receiver isn't exactly the best situation to be in. That's not to say Sterling Shepard is bad. No, he's pretty good. In fact, he's one of the more underrated receivers in the entire NFL. But at the end of the day, he's not number one, so he should not be your best wide receiver, right? The idea that people have that cutting Sterling Shepard is a move that the Giants should make this offseason, to me, doesn't make any sense, especially when we're in a position that we need as many good playmakers as we could get, as many good wide receivers as we could get. You're going to be out here getting rid of our best one. And real quickly, I do want to give a shout out to Bobby Skinner and Justin Penick of Talking Giants. They have their Talking Giants podcast over here. I'm sure a lot of you guys, if not, you know I'm saying, all of you already know who they are, but shout out to them. These Sterling Shepard stats that I'm going to give you guys, they were tweeting around a couple days ago, I want to say 3 or 4 days ago. And then after that, somehow, some way, the whole conversation about trading Shepard or cutting him got started up. But shout out to those guys. Go check them out if you already have not. Now, I think the reason this even got started is because of the whole cap situation that the entire NFL is in right now. And I want to repeat that. Back when I didn't even give this its own video, I kind of gave it a segment in one of my videos, I think around like 2 weeks ago or so. And I was saying the reason I'm not giving it this whole video is because it's really not that bad, because the entire league is dealing with the salary cap deficit. Like, the entire league got cut like around $25 million. So the Giants really should not be worrying too much about anything. And Giants fans shouldn't be either. I feel like that's why Mara said in his end of year press conference that, you know, they're going to do their job. There's nothing to worry about in terms of managing the cap and whatnot. Because everybody has to figure it out. Every single team has to find a way to regain that 20 mil, or at the very least to get their team in a position where they could re-sign their players and maybe sign a couple others, right? But the reason this came about is because Shepard, well, he is one of our bigger cap hits in the 2021 offseason right now. He carries a cap hit of $9 million flat. And then if we were to cut him, depending whether or not we cut him, you know, June 1st or not, he would be $6 million cap hit or a $3 million cap hit. And then, of course, if we trade him, you know, depending on how the trade goes, I'm pretty sure the team that he goes to will just take that entire $9 million cap hit. Now, people want to get Shepard off here because according to overcap.com, right now, he's the sixth biggest cap hit on our salary cap, right? But even then, even if, you know, not if, but even because of the fact that he carries that cap hit, we should not get rid of him. I'll repeat that we're in need of guys like him, and Shepard was not part of the problem in 2020. Like, the problem with this offense was that it was two things, really. Jason Garrett, who I've been like on the board since week four of cutting this man and replacing him with a better offensive coordinator. Obviously, that's not going to happen, and I'm completely fine with that fact. I just hope that he improves his play calling, improves his decision making, and maybe improves his playbook a little bit in 2020. But the two biggest reasons our offense failed were Jason Garrett and his play calling, and the fact that our wide receivers could not catch the ball. However, Sterling Shepard was not one of those wide receivers. In fact, he was one of the wide receivers, and has been for the entirety of his career, that knows how to catch the ball, knows how to hold on to it, and, you know, gets a little bit with yards after the catch to improve the play. Shepard is one of those guys. He was one of the only wide receivers on the Giants that was a reliable target no matter when you throw to him, all right? And once again, shout out to Talking Giants for this. His catch rate in 2020 with Daniel Jones was 79.2%. That's basically, you know, an 80% catch rate with Daniel Jones. That is incredible. His overall catch rate was 73.3%. You know, you factor in Colt McCoy and whatnot. That is still pretty good. With first downs on 66 of his catches, 37 of them went for first down. And that's an improvement over 2019, where he had just 29 of 57 that went for first down. And the dude has had just 2 drops on 173 targets in the last 2 years. How do you get rid of that? Tell me. When what we're looking for is people that could just catch the ball and hold on to it and try and make a play with it. That is our need. You're telling me you're going to make it an even bigger need? And in addition to that, you add on the second need of now we need another slot receiver? Now, and that's not even taking into account the fact that Sterling Shepard, he's not just a slot receiver. Now, is he best in the slot? 100%. Is that what we should use him as? 100%. But he could be put on the outside. He's not extremely versatile, but he can be put on the outside. He does well on the outside. When you put him out there every now and again, you could use him in different positions, different packages, you know, different routes and whatnot. And that was part of going back to the problems with the 2020 offense. That was part of the problem. Jason Garrett just did not use his guys, you know, correctly. Shepard was just relegated to a stereotypical slot receiver where all he did was go into the slot and catch balls from the slot. He was never really bounced outside, never really asked to do anything a bit more complex. I mean, one of my biggest gripes with Garrett was that his route scheme was so simple, too simple to work in the modern day NFL. And that same thing goes for Golden Tate as well. Golden Tate, with just his, you know, his fiasco with Joe Judge and the coaching staff during the season, he kind of had like a right to feel the way that he did. Obviously, I don't agree with the way it happened, you know, the way he went about it, or I guess I should say the way his family went about it. But Tate had a reason, and I said that in my video. I am on Tate's side in terms of they're not getting the ball to him. What was the point in signing him if they were just not going to use him at all? You know what I'm saying? Tate had a point in the fact that the Giants almost purposely excluded him from the offense when him, like Shepard, is one of those guys that is pretty good at catching the football. You know what I mean? He's pretty good at making contested catches, and the Giants just did not use him in that regard. You know, once again, going back to Jason Garrett, same thing with Sterling Shepard here. And once again, I'm not saying he's our number one, and while right now he is technically our number one, is that a good thing? Not necessarily. Doesn't mean that it's a bad thing either, but the plan for this offseason is to add more weapons to the good ones that we have. Sterling Shepard is currently the best wide receiving weapon that we have. It makes no sense to cut him at all, even if, you know, his contract is a big cap hit for us, you know, making, you know, with that $9 million hit. You know what you should do? If it's possible, try and restructure it. I'm sure Shepard, you know, he might be open to that and whatnot, but don't go and cut the dude. And I just think generally it's not a good idea. I don't know why some Giants fans are entertaining it. And like, Shepard is one of those guys where like, he's a true Giant. Like, I don't know, man. You know, like Saquon's a true Giant. You know, Daniel Jones is a true Giant. Shepard is one of those guys as well. You know, he does, you know, he's pretty good for the team. He's pretty good in the locker room, pretty good with the media. Like, he's just a Giant. You know, he's one of those guys you can't really imagine in another jersey as well. But that's just my take on it. You guys let me know what you think. I've just been seeing that floating around. Put your comments down below. All that, I'm out. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. I'll catch y'all in the next one.